Ashley here, and in this video, I'm going to be giving myself a blowout with a product I've never used before. I've been seeing it all over the internet. I've read really great reviews. I watched some videos on it, and then I saw it on sale online, so I ended up grabbing it, and today I'm gonna give it a try. The product is the Revlon Salon one-step hair dryer and volumizer. So it was on sale. I got it for like 35% off. It's usually like 60 bucks, I'm pretty sure. But so this is a hair dryer brush pretty much. So it says here it gives smooth blowouts in half of the time. Okay. Less heat related damage. Okay, I'm still gonna use a heat protectant, always. And a few other things, tangle free combination bristles, lightweight, all that good stuff. So this is it right here. And we're gonna see how it works today. So I haven't opened this yet, I've never used it. I'm just gonna be honest on here and see how it works. So before I open this up, show you what's inside and use it on my hair, I just wanted to tell you how I prep my hair for this blowout. I usually do this anytime I'm gonna do a blowout or straighten my hair. I like to use products that are moisturizing and strengthening. So I started with the Living Proof Restore shampoo. So this is going to hydrate your hair, reverse damage, strengthen your hair. Then I always do a protein treatment before I straighten my hair, blowouts, whatever. I went in with this one here from Camille Rose. This is their protein treatment. Love this stuff. And then after, anytime I do a protein treatment, because that's strengthening and it's not really gonna moisturize your hair, I always follow up with a conditioner, and I followed up with the Living Proof. Woo! The Living Proof Restore Conditioner. It does the same thing, reverses damage, strengthens, all that good stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and section off my hair and get started on this blowout. As a base, I'm going to be using this Living Proof Restore Perfecting Spray, so it's a leave-in, and a heat protectant. So it's gonna give me moisture, it's gonna strengthen my hair and protect it from the heat, even though this says here that it's less heat related damage, but still we're using heat on our hair, so we want to make sure we use a heat protectant. Now that you know how I'm prepping my hair and all that good stuff, we're gonna open this up and get to using it. So first impression, it is pretty big, but it does feel very lightweight. And I'm gonna read the instructions, just make sure I'm using it right. I did watch a couple videos on how people used it, but I'm just gonna read the directions. Section off my hair, put my spray, and let's do this. All right, so my hair is sectioned off, and it was funny, I was about to get started and I could not find the button. I'm like, is it supposed to turn on right when I plug it in? It's actually right here. I should have read the directions more clearly. So you just twist it. There is a cool, low, and high option. You could see there, and it is loud, like a blow dryer, of course. So there it is. Okay, finally, let's go in with this brush. Okay, so not bad. Definitely just be careful when like holding the top. I definitely burnt myself, but so far so good. So let's keep on doing the rest of my hair. Done. not bad. My ends definitely need to be cut, so don't mind those, but it feels really good. The only thing is that it is kind of hard to get the roots, so the roots are kind of still a little wavy here, but honestly, not bad. I could probably go in with an actual blow dryer and flatten those out. I love the fact that the brush makes it easy to get this kind of like swoop going on, because I love that. So I'm gonna do the other half, then I'll come on here and give you my final thoughts of this blow dryer brush. So here is the final look, my blowout using this Revlon hair dryer volumizer brush. It definitely is a game changer, makes it super easy to achieve a blowout. And if you're like me and have a hard time doing an actual blow dryer and the bristle brush, this is for you for sure. Because I don't know what it is, I just can't figure it out. But with this brush, it makes it so much easier. And usually when I do a blowout, I can never achieve like a sleek blowout. It's always super poofy. Like this is probably me doing it myself, probably like the sleekest I've gotten a blowout. So I'm very impressed with that. The only thing I would say is it's kind of hard to get close to the roots. Like some of my roots are still a little wavy, puffy. I don't know if you could see there. Just a little bit, not bad. I am very impressed with this. It was very easy to use. It is very lightweight. Just be careful when you're holding it, when you're doing your hair, if you're using the two hands like I was majority of the time, just be careful you're holding on to this part, because I definitely burnt myself like touching the metal here and it was very hot. I definitely recommend it if you're trying to find an easier way to achieve some really nice blowouts. Overall, I'm very happy with this Revlon one-step hair dryer volumizer, a great purchase. Make sure you check out the description box. I'll leave all the product info there, especially about this brush here. If you've used the Revlon hair dryer brush volumizer, let me know in the comments your thoughts on it, what color you have. They have tons of cute colors of this, and maybe some tips you have. I feel like it was pretty easy to use for my first time, so I really liked it, but hey, I feel like each time you use it, it gets better and better. You kind of become a pro. Practice makes perfect, but I am very happy with my results. Probably my best blowout I've ever done for myself. Okay, wait 1 second. Before you go, I want to jump back on here and just show you my hair after going through with the flat iron. So after I finish filming and kind of give you my final results of the blow dryer and how my hair looked, I was like, you know what? Let me just straighten it and see how easy it is. That was the fastest I've ever gone through my hair using the flat iron. Literally one pass, it took me like 15, 20 minutes to get through my hair. Usually it takes like an hour after blowing it out. This thing is a game changer. So this is my hair after doing the blowout and then going in with my flat iron. Okay, I tucked under the ends here because they're a little crusty. Like I said in the beginning of the video, I do need a trim, but I am just so happy with my results. This does not look bad at all. So again, yes. Yes to this. All right, that's all I wanted to tell you. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.